What's up guys, Senaid here from CoinPassiveIncome.com. In today's tutorial I will talk about MySQL triggers. So the triggers we use to execute when some data change happens inside the table. So we set triggers for the commands insert, update and delete. So now in the first part of this tutorial I will use my whiteboard to explain about triggers and to show you what you exactly need to know and what is the syntax. And in the second part of this video tutorial I'll use my PC and workbench to show you how actually do it directly inside MySQL. So let's do it. So now I'm here at my whiteboard, and before I show you the exact syntax that you need to know for triggers in SQL, I just want to show you and create one table for you that you first need to learn and always remember, and if you know that one you will easily create triggers. So as I already said, triggers we use when we want to change something inside the table and then we want to trigger. So we have the triggers for insert, update and delete command. So let me just draw one table. So I will say here command type, and here I will say keyword. Okay. And I will say here insert, update and delete. For now, just remember this table as is, and later in this tutorial you will find why we need to know this table. So now, for the type that we have for the insert is before and after, and the same applies for the update and delete. So the type of the trigger can be before insert command happens or after insert command happens, and the same for the update and delete. And for the keyword, now for the insert we only have the new, because for this command we don't have any old data, we only have new data. For the update we have old data that is before change, and we have new data that will be after change. So we have old and new, and for the delete we only have old data. Okay, now we know this table, and I will write you here the trigger. But for example, let's say that we want to create the history, the table that will be history for all users, so we can to that user show all the changes that he made on his profile, just as example. So like always I'll use a red marker for the SQL that is always the same, and black for something that is changing all the time. So we will say something like delimiter and we now use the delimiter to change what is already set, so that MySQL will interpret this data. He will use everything that is in between this delimiter and the one that we will have later here. And if there is semicolon like we always had, then MySQL will just execute SQL command but command. So after that you say create trigger, and now we need to specify the name of this trigger, and I will say create history. And now we need to write, we need to know which command we want to do and also what will be the type. So for example, for this here we will use the update command, and it will execute before or after update. So we'll say delimiter create trigger create history after, sorry, after update on, and now we need to specify the table on which this trigger will exist, and it will say users for each row, and it will now say begin. And now here we need to write the command that will execute once this trigger is triggered. So we will say insert Intel history, and now we need to specify the columns. We will say name, email, weight, married, expiration date. I will continue down here. Values. And now we need to use the keyword that we have. So we are going to use the old data from this table and insert it here. So we'll say old.email. No. Old.name, old.email, old.weight, old.married, and old.expiration date. Okay, and now we need to put end to finish this trigger. We'll say end and use this sign here. And now we need to change the delimiter again to the default one. So we'll say delimiter, and that's it. So now when we analyze this code, we will see that first I have changed the delimiter, then I said the command create trigger, and the name of it is create history. After update on users for each row, begin, and we have here end and delimiter. And here is the command. So for example, if now the user with ID 1 change his name and email. And for example, now it's N12EM12. And if he changes to like this, now the old data will be stored here. And it will say one, name will be M12, and so on. So on that way, we have created the history for this user, and we will do that since we set here for each row. We will do the same thing for all other users. As you can see, this trigger will automatically execute each time that there is some update. And this is very useful when we use something like calculating the data in the other tables or deleting data in other tables and so on. So let me show now on my PC how we are going to do this inside MySQL Workbench. So now I'm here at my PC and I'm going to show you how to create trigger in the MySQL Workbench. So the first thing obviously is to open MySQL Workbench, write the command to use the database that you want to work on, and now I have here the two commands that just I want to show what do we have inside those two tables. So in the first table, as you can see here, this is users table and this is the data that we have. Okay, and now in the table users backup, we don't have any data. Okay, and now we want to create trigger that will for each update inside the users table save that update to our users backup table. So now let's write that trigger. So like we said, delimiter and now we need to say create trigger, create history, that is just the name, after update on users for each row, begin, and here we have end, and now we need to switch it back. So in the first part we have, like I said, create trigger, then we have the name of the trigger, then it's after update, which is from the table that I have showed you, the table and for each row. Now we need to write here the SQL query that will happen once this trigger executes. So we'll say insert into users backup, and we will say ID, first name, last name, email, password, token, expire, values, old.id, old.first, name, and now let's try to execute this. Okay, down below we can see that it's successfully executed, and also here on the left side we can refresh this, and inside here triggers we can see that we have create history. Okay, and now let's try to update some data inside our users table. But before we do that, okay, let's see what we have. So we have, let's say for the user with ID 1, we have first name Senaid 123, last name Bacinovic, and so on. So now let's say update users, set first name equal Senaid, where ID equal 1. So let's execute this command. Okay, select everything from the users. We can see that the user data has been changed. And now let's see what we have inside the user's backup table. Okay, as you remember, this table was empty, and now here we have the old data that was before our update. And we can see now that this trigger is automatically executed once we run the update command. The one more command that I want to show is how to delete the existing trigger. So we need to use the command drop trigger, and we need to write its name. It's create history, and let's execute. Okay, and here at the left side, if we now refresh, we can see that there isn't any trigger. And now if we try to execute this command again, and let's see what happens inside user's backup. As you can see, there isn't new row because we don't have our trigger anymore. So as you can see guys, those can be very useful in most cases. So you just need to remember the crucial things, like that we can create triggers only on the three commands, which is insert, update and delete. You need to know that we have before and after type of the triggers for those commands, and that for insert commands we have keyword new, for the update we have keywords new and old, and for the delete we have keyword old, and pretty much that's it. So guys, I hope you understand this, it's not too complicated, and if you have any question please comment below and I will be more than happy to answer it. And also if you like this video, please like it and share it, and see you in the next video. Bye bye.